Also guys, Manash here, and today we have Guardian against the convention clash Nameless Thanos boss. So this is a fight where you can use pretty much any good champ. Guardian isn't particularly the best at it, although he is far from the worst. He is definitely above average, just because he has some good damage output and that high block efficiency. So now for the first real phase, what I like to do is just to throw the special one right from the get-go, because you notice that Thanos actually takes a bit of time to recover after switching phases. And throwing a special attack will disable that stun reflection ability he's got going on. And now what I want to do is actually bait his heavy attack by holding block to prevent him from throwing a special one, just so I can get a couple more hits in and build a bit more power. And now he does throw the special one, so I'm going to parry those hits just to build more power. And now what I need to do is hit his block to build 2 bars of power. And now I can throw a special 2, which will take him to the next phase. So yeah, Guardian works really well for that phase. Okay, now once again, you can rush in, and in this phase your controls will be inverted until you do land a light ending combo. So you have to do a combo with at least 4 hits and end with a light attack. And his special 2 will reactivate inverter controls. And you'll notice that some of those hits are just mere illusions. You only need to dex the ones that are a bit brighter. And you can punish it, but if the last hit is the one that you have to dex, then it's a lot more difficult, because he can recover relatively quickly from that attack. So I'm not sure if it's safe to reliably punish that one, but if it is the first hit of the second wave, then yeah, it's a lot easier. So now I decide to throw another special 2, but it's not going to do that much damage because he does have that safeguard mechanic. But at least it has a couple of hits on it, so yeah, those small numbers can at least add up a bit. But yeah, generally it's just safer to parry after the special 2 and then do a light ending combo. The only thing is, when he drops to 40%, he does become stun immune. And this is where I like to hold block a bit more, you know, just to bait a heavy attack to get an opening while preventing him from throwing that special 2. Sometimes you'll still throw it even while you're blocking, just because he's very likely to throw the special attack when he does have 2 bars of power. But yeah, usually it does work out. Managed to get him down to 31%. And now we're in the final phase. Now this is probably the most trickiest phase, at least for me it is, because now you have to intercept to remove the indestructible, and he will be unstoppable at the time as well. So if you don't do it properly, then you can actually get punished. But when you do successfully intercept, you remove the indestructible, but it will return after 1 second. So what I did here is I saved my special 3, so I can throw it while he doesn't have indestructible, and then it will only come back after the animation ends. You'll also notice that when you're near Thanos, you do get a stacking armor break on you. And when you do intercept, it will get transferred to him. So if you can stack a lot of those armor breaks, you can do some very nice special 3 damage. Also, landing a successful intercept will give you protection in the form of that pink indestructible looking icon, which will basically prevent you from losing more than 20% health from your special 3. Usually I only take one special 3 in this fight, so it's not too bad. The only thing is, after that special 3, you are gonna be sort of cornered, or you're gonna have very little space to intercept because you're gonna be very close to the corner. So yeah, fortunately once again I can intercept very successfully, and now I've got 10 of those armor breaks, so this should do a good amount of damage. Although not quite enough to end him, but fortunately I can get a very quick intercept after the animation ends and he goes down. So yeah, quite a fun fight with Guardian, and I wish Kabam would design more fights like this where it becomes less about having the right champs and more about having the right approach and how effectively you can complete certain tasks. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you soon.